Welcome to OGYES. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on the channel, we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services. And for that purpose, we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So friends, currently we have 12 series that focus on your prelims and one series that target your mains. And what we do in these prelims oriented series, we have basically divided your whole syllabus into 12 large subtopics, and what we do, we daily cover 2 subtopics, and in this manner in 6 days your all 12 subtopics are covered, and this process goes on and on in a cyclic manner, and we will continue to do so till 31st May. So why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because on 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC CSE 2019. So friends, this lecture is about the economy. So this is lecture number 8 of economy. So let's see what are the MCQs of the in today's lecture. The first question is, which of the following statements about enforcement directorate is incorrect? A. ED is appointed on the approval of the appointments committee of the cabinet headed by prime minister. B. It functions under the aegis of Central Bureau of Investigation. C. It is responsible for tracing black money and hawala trade cases. D. None of the above. So we have to choose that which of the statements is incorrect. Let me tell you friends that the B statement is incorrect. It doesn't function under the Central Bureau of Investigation. So the answer is B. So the explanation part of friends, if this question you can, if you want the explanations also, then you can contact us at this email ID, that is achieveies21@gmail.com, or the contact number 8968426481. So there is a minimum subscription fee in case you want the explanation PDFs, and that has been kept as minimum as possible for the purpose of your affordability as well as for the purpose of our motivation. So in case you want the explanations also, then you can contact on this given number or email ID. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements with reference to International Monetary Fund. First, it is governed by International Monetary and Financial Committee. Second, one of the aims of IMF is to promote exchange stability. Third, India is the biggest borrower from IMF. So friends, we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you friends that only one statement is correct, and that is one of the aims of IMF is to promote exchange stability. So the answer would be D, that is second only. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, Gender Development Index released by United Nations Development Program is A. The ratio of female HDI and male HDI. B. Inequality adjusted Gini index for females. C. A joint index of labor force participation, reproductive health and political participation of women. D. None of the above. So we have to choose that which of the following is correct. So friends, Gender Development Index is basically the ratio of female HDI and male HDI, and it helps in measuring the level of the gap of development, human development among male and female. So the answer would be A. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is fourth. Consider the following about International Bank for Reconstruction and Development. First, it was created to help Europe rebuild after the Second World War. Second, it is owned jointly by United States and European Union. Third is, it supports long-term human and social development that private creditors may not finance. Fourth, it provides advisory services in public debt and asset management to help governments. So we have to choose that which of the above is correct. Let me tell you friends that second is not correct, because it is managed and owned by all the countries that are member to it. So it is not owned just by United States and European Union. So the rest of the statements are correct, that is 1, 3 and 4. So the answer would be D, that is 1, 3 and 4. So the solution is D. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, a lot of expenditures in the annual budget are charged on the Consolidated Fund of India. The purpose behind this is to A. Increase the efficiency of spending. B. Prevent march rush. C. Reduce the expenditure overlap between several departments. D. None of the above. So friends, the answer is none of the above, because this expenditure that is charged in Consolidated Fund of India is to ensure the independence of certain type of institutions. The solution is D. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, fiscal capacity term is used by policy makers to refer to. First, openness of an economy. Second, government's tax and expenditure volumes. Third, private sector savings. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you friends that only one statement is correct, and that is government's tax and expenditure volume. So the solution is B. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, why geometric mean is used in computation of human development index rather than earlier methodology of arithmetic mean? So in 2010, friends, the practice of calculating HDI with the geometric mean began. So what is the purpose behind it? So we have to choose that which of the following is correct. First, it ensures that low achievement in one dimension is not anymore linearly compensated for by high achievement in another dimension. Second, it ensures that geometric means capture qualitative aspects of human development indicators while incorporating environmental sustainability. So we have to choose the correct. Let me tell you, friends, that only one statement is correct, that is first. So it ensures that that the low achievement in one dimension is not compensated by high achievement in the other another dimension. So that's why now geometric mean is used and not arithmetic mean. So the answer is A. Let's move on to the next question. Eighth question is, consider the following about the Patent Cooperation Treaty of the World Intellectual Property Organization. So we have to choose that what is correct about this Patent Cooperation Treaty of the World Intellectual Property Organization. First, PCT makes it impossible to seek patent protection for an invention simultaneously in a large number of countries by filing a single international patent application. Second, PCT shifts the authority of granting patents from national offices to the WIPO. So we have to choose that which of the above is correct. Let me tell you that first statement is correct. It is possible to seek the basically it is for the purpose of getting patent from a large number of countries simultaneously. So second is not correct, but the first is correct. So the answer would be A. Let's move on to the next question. Ninth question is, farmers clubs are actively promoted by NABARD. They are first a grassroots level informal forum of farmers in the village. Second, a committee of directors of major cooperatives in a village cluster. C, a technical extension center for the Krishi Vigyan Kendras. And D is the non-governmental organization that are officially designated the responsibility of implementing rural farmer welfare scheme. So we have to choose the correct. Let me tell you, friends, that farmer clubs are basically, these are grassroots level informal forum of farmers in the village. So the answer would be A. So let's move on to the next statement. Next question, that is the last question of the day. 10th question, consider the following about the Global Multidimensional Poverty Index developed by Oxford Poverty and Human Development Initiative and United Nations Development Program. First, it captures not only the incidence of poverty but also the intensity of poverty in terms of specific deprivations. Second, it includes the extent of unemployment and functional labor skills as key components in determining the index. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you, friends, that this Multidimensional Poverty Index is basically, it captures the incidence of poverty and the intensity of poverty in terms of specific deprivations. So the answer is, only one statement is correct, so the answer would be A. So this is all about today's lecture of economy, that is lecture number 8. And if you like the questions, then do hit a like, do share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And lastly, friends, if you want to get the explanation PDFs of these MCQs, you can mail us at this email ID, that is achieveias21@gmail.com, or at this contact number, that is 8968426481. So certainly there will be minimum cost for it, but it has been kept as minimum as possible for the purpose of your affordability. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. Also ensure that you subscribe to our channel and also press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the important notifications about the updates that we do on our channel. So thank you, friends. Have a very nice